Hello students, in previous lecture we have covered the theory part of complex number. Now this lecture will be totally devoted to the problem. So here is the first problem. We have assumed that I is root under minus 1. Then we have to find the value of 4 plus 5 times half minus half plus I root 3 upon 2 to the power 34 plus 3 times this complex number, that is minus half plus I root 3 upon 2 times 335. So, we have this complex number, say, let us name it as Z. So, Z is minus half plus I root 3 upon 2, right? So, this is in X plus IY format, right? So, since here is power, so it is better to change this in Euler's form, that is R e to the power I theta. R e to the power I theta form, right? So, what is the value of R? R is the modulus of this complex number, mod Z, which is equal to under root minus half square plus root 3 upon 2 square, isn't it? This is equal to 1 by 4 plus 3 by 4, which is nothing but 1, right? So, R is 1 and theta is cos tan inverse y by x, which is root 3 upon 2 upon minus half, tan inverse root 3 upon 2 upon minus half, which is equal to tan inverse minus root 3, right? So, tan inverse minus root 3, if we see what is its principal argument, principal value of argument, that is the value of angle such that it is less than either less than pi or greater than minus pi. So this value tan inverse minus root 3, that means this value, this angle exists in second quadrant, right? Tan 60 degree is root 3 and tan 120 degree is minus root 3. So this is, we can write it as 120 degree in degrees or 2 pi upon 3 radians. Right? So, this complex number Z is R 1 e to the power I 2 pi by 3. Z is e to the power I 2 pi by 3, right? We have just changed this complex number from Cartesian form to Euler's form. Now, we will be just substituting this complex number here and finding the value. We will be seeing that how easy it becomes. So, the expression is 4 plus 5z to the power 334 plus 3z to the power 335, right? So, z to the power 334 is equal to the power I 2 pi upon 3 to the power 334 is equal to e to the power I 2 pi upon 3. 334 can be written as 333 plus 1. We have written it as in a multiple of 3 plus something. That is, something will be 0, either 0, 1 or 2. Any number can be written in the form of multiples of 3 plus minus 0, 1 and 2, right? So, we have written 334 in 333, which is a multiple of 3 plus 1. This is because 3 will cancel 3 and we will be getting e to the power I 2 pi into e to the power I 2 pi upon 3, right? Okay. 2 pi into some constant k, this will give, which will be again equal to e to the power I 2 pi. Its value is 1, right? Because this angle is 2 pi k, which is value is 1. And so, we have the value of z to the power 334 as e to the power I 2 pi by 3 only, which is equal to z only, right? Okay. Now, the value of z to the power 335, we will be doing in similar way. E to the power I 2 pi upon 3 to the power 330, it is 335, that right? 333 plus 2, isn't it? Which is equal to e to the power I 2 pi, same k, into e to the power I 4 pi upon 3, right? Which is equal to, this is value is 1, its value is 1, and its value is e to the power I 4 pi upon 3. So, e to the power I 2 pi upon 3, if we see e to the power I 4 pi upon 3, this its value is minus half minus I root 3 by 2, right? We have converted this from polar from Euler's form again to Cartesian form. Now, now this will become very simple now. As we substitute the values 4 plus 5 z to the power 334, which is z itself, that is minus half plus I root 3 by 2 plus 3 times z to the power 335, which is this number, right? Minus half minus I root 3 by 2. That is, this number is actually conjugate of this number. So, if you separate real and imaginary part, the real part is 4 minus 5 by 2 and minus 3 by 2. Right? Minus 5 by 2 plus minus 3 by 2 is minus 8 by 2, which is minus 4. So, 4 minus 4, 0 as a real part, and imaginary part is 5 times root 3 by 2 and 3 times minus 3 times root 3 by 2. That is 5 minus 3 times root 3 by 2, which is equal to root I, which is equal to root 3. That means this number is I root 3. So the expression 4 plus 5z plus 3, 4 plus 5z to the power 334 plus 3z to the power 335. This expression converges to, that means this results to I root 3. Okay, and the life becomes simple while changing this by changing this numbers, complex number in Euler's form. Okay. So this is the answer for this question. Okay. Now let's have another problem. Okay, so this is the problem. We have a regular polygon. Okay, regular polygon means a polygon which has all sides equal, all sides are equal. That means all vertices are separated with respect to other vertices at equal distances. That is, say, if we are talking about regular polygon of side 4, then it is a square, right? Okay. Or if we are talking about, say, regular polygon of size 5, then this is of type pentagon, this type. So all these sides are equal. That means this is a regular polygon. So we have a n-sided regular polygon, a1, a2, a3, dot dot dot, an are the vertices of the regular polygon, right? And we have the relation between vertices a1, a2, a3 and a4, right? What this is basically, a1, a2 will denote the length of distance between a1 and a2, vertices a1 and a2. And this is similar, the length between vertices a1 and a3, okay? And this is the length between vertices a1 and a4. So we have the relation, this relation, and we don't know what is the value of n. So we have to find the value of n if this relation exists. Okay. So this is the problem. See, this problem doesn't seem that this can be done with complex number, but we will be doing it from a complex number point of view, and we will be seeing how easily we can do that. Okay. This is actually a geometry problem, right? So we will be doing with the help of complex number. Applying our concepts of complex number in this problem. Okay, so we have n-sided polygon. Let us name the vertices a1, a2, a3. This n-sided polygon, let us assume that this n-sided polygon is in our Argand plane, complex number plane. Okay, this is Argand plane, say. real z axis, imaginary z axis. So we have this regular polygon in this our R1 plane, right? And its vertices, let us denote the vertices point, each point, vertices are points. So let us denote each vertices with a complex numbers assigned to it. So we have inside the regular polygon 3, 4, let us name this vertices as A1, this is A2, this is A3, this is A4, this is A5, and so on. Here is, let us assume this is AN, okay? So we have inside the polygon with vertices A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, dot 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 AN. And this regular polygon has a center, okay? Let us denote this center by A0, okay? A0 is the center. Center is a point from which all the vertices are equidistant, okay? If 5-sided regular polygon is there, say pentagon, then here is the center such that all these vertices are equal distance. This is equal to this is equal, this is equal, this is, these all 5 distances are equal, lengths are equal. That means from this point, all vertices are equal distance, okay? So we have this, we call this as a center of this polygon, okay? So since this is in our R1 plane, so these points are nothing but complex numbers. So A1 is actually Z1, A2 is actually Z2. Let us name these numbers as Z1, Z2. This is Z3, say this is Z4, and this is say Z0. Okay, this is Z5 similarly. Okay, then now since this polygon is a regular polygon, if we want to find say this angle, if you want to know what is this angle, then there is a this the whole angle which if we rotate this the whole angle form is 2 pi, right? The complete angle. And since there are n sides, so each angle is 2 pi divided by n, right? Because we are dividing this complete angle in n parts, okay? So this angle is 2 pi, each angle is 2 pi upon n, 2 pi upon n, 2 pi upon n, right? Okay? So, now suppose we want to find the length of this side, or we want to find the relation, like what we have done in rotation, complex number rotation. Suppose this is complex number Z1, this is complex number Z2, this is complex number Z3. Then, and this angle is alpha, then we have seen that Z2 minus Z1 upon Z3 minus Z1 is equal to modulus of Z2 minus Z1 upon Z3 minus Z1 into e to the power I alpha, right? This thing we have already seen, okay? Okay, using this relation, if we want to write the distance, the A1, A2, okay? So, we have the relation from A1, A2, if we take vertices like this, say we are taking 3 vertices, this is A0, okay? This is A1 and this is A2, say, okay? So, this complex number is Z1, here complex number is Z2 and here complex number is Z1. And this angle is of course 2 pi upon n, isn't it? So, we can write what? This Z2 upon Z0, Z2 minus Z0, from this, the same relation, Z2 minus Z0 upon Z1 minus Z0 is equal to modulus of Z2 minus Z0 upon Z1 minus Z0 into e to the power I 2 pi upon n, right? The same thing we have done, whatever the theory is, we are applying this theory here, the same thing, okay? Since this is a regular polygon, this side is equal to this side. That means modulus of Z2 minus Z0. This represents, the side represents modulus of Z2 minus Z1, right? And this side represents modulus of Z1 minus Z2. Z1 minus Z0. So these two are equal because this is a regular polygon. So this will be nothing but 1. Okay. So we can write Z2 minus Z0 is equal to Z1 minus Z0 into e to the power I 2 pi upon n. Okay. So we have the relation here. Let me erase this. And let me write the relation. What is the relation is? The relation is z2 minus z0 is equal to z1 minus z0 into e to the power I 2 pi upon n. Okay? So, this is the relation we have. If we are not considering these three vertices, if we are considering say a0, a1 and a4, say if we are considering a0, let us name this a4 and this is here something is a1, okay, then what is this angle? This angle is this angle plus this angle plus this angle, so 3 times 2 pi upon n, this angle is 3 times 2 pi upon n, right? If we are taking a0, a1 and a4, right, that means if we will be taking rth point, that means rth vertices among this n vertices, so we will be getting say this is if ar, this is a0 and this this is a1 and this is a0, so this angle will be r minus 1 times 2 pi upon n. Okay, since this is a4, this is 4 minus 1 which is 3 into 2 pi upon n, so if this vertices, this is rth vertices, vertex, this is the rth vertex, so this angle is r minus 1 2 pi upon n, right? So we can write it as zr minus z0 is equal to z1 minus z0 into e to the power I r minus 1 2 pi upon n. Okay, just we have replaced this z2 by zr and this 2 pi upon n angle by r minus 1 2 pi upon n, because this is the angle which is existing here, right? Okay, so now we have the relation this. Let me erase the problem. I hope you have all noted the problem. This relation here. So we have the relation zr minus z0 is equal to z1 minus z0 e to the power I r minus 1 2 pi upon n, right? That means zr minus z, let us find what is a1, a2. A1, a2 is nothing but distance between vertex A1 and vertex A2, that means distance between complex number Z1 and Z2, that means this is Z1 minus Z2, modulus of Z1 minus Z2, isn't it? Okay, or equivalently Z2 minus Z1. Okay, so we have Z2, from here we can calculate the Z2, the value of Z2 will be Z0 plus Z1 minus Z0 into the e to the power I 2 pi upon n, right? We have just substituted 2 in place of r because we are finding z2. So z2 will be, so z2 minus z1 will be, z2 minus z1 will be this minus z1, z0 plus z1 minus z0 to the power I 2 pi upon n minus z1, z0, right? I mean this is z1 minus z1, okay, which is equal to z0 minus z1 into 1 minus e to the power I 2 pi upon n, isn't it? See, this is z0 minus z1 and if we take this common, z0 minus z1, this will become minus and we will, here we will have 1 minus this number. So, we have z2 minus z1 is this value, okay, right? Similarly, if we are calculating say for any other vertices, rth vertices, zr minus z1, then this will be z0 minus z1, 1 minus e to the power I r minus 1 2 pi upon n, isn't it? This value, okay? So now just we have to place this, the modulus of this value, this number in this expression and we will be finding the value of n then. Okay, so what is the modulus of this value? The modulus of this value is modulus of z0 minus z1 into modulus of this number, that is e to the power I r minus 1 2 pi upon n, right? So now we will be calculating a1 a2. What is a1 a2? a1 a2 is okay, let me first find the modulus of 1 minus e to the power I r minus 1 2 pi upon n can be written in the form of 1 minus in a Cartesian form we can write it as cos 2 pi r minus 1 upon n plus that is this is minus so this is minus I sin 2 pi r minus 1 upon n, right? Okay, this expression is fine. So this expression we have a trigonometric identity, that is 1 minus cos theta, okay, we always write it as 2 cos square theta by 2. This is from the identity cos square theta minus sin square theta is cos 2 theta. So changing this sin square theta in cos square theta, 1 minus cos square theta, that is, so 2 cos square theta minus 2 cos square theta minus 1 is equal to cos 2 theta, and this can be written as this will be written as 1 2 sin square theta by 2. Okay, if you change it in sin square theta, see 1 minus sin square theta minus sin square theta is equal to cos 2 theta, right? So 2 sin square theta will be 1 minus cos 2 theta upon 2. Okay, that is 2 sin square theta is 1 minus cos 2 theta, cos 2 theta, that is 1 minus cos theta is 2 sin square theta by 2. So if we write this as 1 minus cos 2 times this, so we can write it as 2 sin square r minus 1 pi upon n. Okay, and this can be written as, of course, I into 2 sin pi into r minus 1 upon n into cos pi into r minus 1 upon n. From the identity, sin 2 theta is equal to 2 sin theta cos theta. Okay, so we have written this, expanded this sin 2 theta in using this identity, 2 sin theta cos theta, 2 sin theta cos theta. If we take common, what? That is 2 sin pi r minus 1 upon n. If we take this quantity common, this number will become 2 sin r minus 1 pi upon n times sin r minus 1 pi upon n minus I cos pi upon pi r minus 1 upon n, right? Okay, so this quantity will become this value, this complex number. Okay, so if you want to find the modulus of this number, so we have this complex number and this is the r. So modulus of this is the same number, and the modulus of this is square plus this square under root, which if you check, this value is 1. That is, modulus of this number is 1. This is square, sin square theta plus cos square theta under root 1, right? So we have modulus of 1 minus e to the power I r minus 1 into 2 pi upon n. Okay, modulus of this number we are getting as 2 into sin r minus 1 pi upon n, right? Modulus of this number we are getting as this value. Okay, so we have a1 a2 as modulus of z2 minus z1, right? We have a1, a2 as modulus of z2 minus z1, okay? Which is modulus of z0 minus z1 into modulus of 1 minus e to the power I 2 pi upon n, right? Okay, so this value is z0 upon modulus of z0 minus z1 into sine in place of r, we can put 1. That means we can put 2 because here is 2. So 2 minus 1, 1 pi upon n. 2 sine pi upon n. 2 sine pi upon n. Okay. Similarly, a1, a3 will be a1, a3 is modulus of z0 minus z1 into 2 sine in place of r. We can substitute 3. 3 minus 1, 2. 2 pi upon n. Okay. And a1, a4 is z0 minus z1, modulus of z0 minus z1 into 2 sine, place of r, we can substitute 4, 4 minus 1, 3, 3 pi upon n. Okay. Now we have a1, a2, a1, a3 and a1, a4. Okay. These three are common. So this thing will get cancelled. So we have the relation 1 upon a1, a2, that is, cancelling the common terms, that is 2 times z0 minus z1 is common in both. 2 times z0 minus z1, modulus of z0 minus z1 is common in both. So, cancelling all the common terms, we have the relation sine pi upon n, 1 upon sine pi upon n is equal to 1 upon sine 2 pi upon n plus 1 upon sine 3 pi upon n, right? So we have this relation, right? Using this relation, we have to find the value of n. So let us try to find the value of n. From here, we can write it as sine 2 pi upon n into sine 3 pi upon n sine 2 pi upon n plus sine 3 pi upon n, right? Using cross multiplication, you can write sine 2 pi upon n into sine 3 pi upon n is equal to sine pi upon n times sine 2 pi upon n plus sine 3 pi upon n. Okay. Again, if we expand this using this formula, sine 2 theta is equal to 2 sine theta cos theta. Okay. So we will be getting 2 sine pi upon n cos pi upon n into sine 3 pi upon n, whatever it is there, is equal to sine pi upon n times whatever is there. So again, sine pi upon n and sine pi upon n will be cancelled. So we have the relation 2 cos pi upon n sine 3 pi upon n is equal to sine 2 pi upon n plus sine 3 pi upon n. Right? Again, using trigonometric identities, because trigonometry is very important and we are using those identities in all over the mathematics which we have learned. So using one more identity, say the value of sine a plus b, what is the value of sine a plus b? This is sine a cos b plus cos a sine b. And what is the value of sine a minus b? It is sine a cos b minus cos a sine b. So if we add these two expressions, so we have 2 sine a cos b as sine a plus b plus sine a minus b, right? using this expression, see, here is also 2 sine A, this is A and this is B, okay, 2 sine A cos B. So we can write it as sine A plus B, which is 3 pi plus pi, 4 pi upon n, plus sine A minus B, which is 3 pi minus pi, 2 pi upon n, sine 2 pi upon n, okay. So this expression is simplified in this expression, and we have already here sine 2 pi upon n plus sine 3 pi upon n. So again, this sine 2 pi upon n and this sine 2 pi upon n will be cancelled, and we have the relation sine 4 pi upon n is equal to sine 3 pi upon n. Final relation. Okay. So now we have the final relation, sine 4 pi upon n is equal to sine 3 pi upon n, okay. That means sine 4 pi upon n minus sine 3 pi upon n is equal to 0. Again, we are using one more identity, sine A minus sine B is equal to 2 sine A minus B upon 2 cos A plus B upon 2. Okay, using this identity we can write it as 2 sine 4 pi minus 3 pi, that is pi upon 2n into cos A plus B, 4 pi plus 3 pi, 7 pi upon 2n is equal to 0. So here we have the two terms. Let us name this term as A and let us name this term as B. A into B is equal to 0. That means either A is 0 or B is 0 or both are 0, right? A into B is 0. That means A is 0 or B is 0 or both are 0. So, say if we take sine pi upon 2n is equal to 0. That means pi upon 2n must be equal to some constant k, positive or negative k constant, k times pi, which means that n should be pi upon 2nk, that is pi will get cancelled, 1 upon 2nk, isn't it? 2k, 1 upon 2k, that is 1 upon 2k, okay? If we put k is here, k is integer, so we are not getting integral value of n, right? If sine pi upon 2n is equal to 0, then we are not getting the integral value of n, but here n is integer. Why n is integer? Because n is the number of vertex of a regular polygon, which must be integer. So we are not getting the value of n as an integer, because this is coming as 1 upon 2k, where k is integer. So no possible value of integer will result 1 upon 2k as an integral value. So this cannot be 0. Sine 2 pi upon n cannot be 0. That means sine pi upon 2n cannot be 0. So this must be 0. Cos 7 pi upon 2n, because this expression is 0. So we have now cos 7 pi upon 2n is equal to 0. That means 7 pi upon 2n must be odd multiple of pi by 2, right? Because cos pi by 2, cos 3 pi by 2, cos 5 pi by 2, cos 7 pi by 2, all odd integral multiples of pi by 2, cos integral multiple of pi by 2 is 0. That means this value must be equal to some odd integral times pi by 2. This 2 will be cancelled. Then n is equal to pi cancel. N is equal to 7 upon 2k plus 1. Now let us put some of the integer value of k such that this n is integer. So if we try to put k is equal to 0, then n is equal to 7. Okay. If we put k is equal to 1, then we are not getting integral value. K is equal to 2, we are not getting integral value. Okay. Again, for k is equal to 3, we are getting integral value. For k is equal to 3, we are getting n is equal to 1. Okay. Right. K is equal to 3. 3 times 2 plus 1, which is equal to 7. 7 by 7, 1. So we are getting 2 integral value of n for 2 integral value of k. That is, for k is equal to 0, we are getting n is equal to 7. For k is equal to 3, we are getting n is equal to 1, right? So n is either 1 or n is 7. So n must be 1 or 7. Right? Now, see, we have n-sided polygon. So n cannot be equal to 1 because polygon cannot have one vertex only. Right? So it should be the vertex number of vertex must be greater than 1. Right? I mean the number of vertex must be greater than 2. 1 is not necessary. 2 is because at least for polygon, three-sided polygon, the number of vertex must be equal to 3. This is the smallest polygon, okay? Which number of vertex having 3? N must be greater than equal to 3. Here n must be greater than equal to 3, right? Otherwise polygon will not exist. So the value, what is the value of n then? The value of n is 7, right? Which satisfy this expression. Okay. So see how beautifully we have used the complex number idea by for finding the value of this n. Okay.